Hi, I'm Sean Romo, Senior Staff Archaeologist for the Jamestown Rediscovery Foundation, and welcome to another episode of Digging Deeper. I joined the Jamestown Rediscovery team back in April, and for most of the last year, my job has been to help manage the archaeological excavations at historic Jamestown. You guys have probably seen me in the field, digging alongside the rest of the archaeology team, and helping to explain to the public what we've been finding. Excavation is only one part of what the archaeology team normally does at historic Jamestown. As we dig, we're of course recording every soil layer and feature that we uncover, and collecting all the artifacts that are in a particular excavation area. Those artifacts get washed in the lab and then analyzed. And then once everything's done, we bring all of our information together, everything we found in the field, all the artifacts from the lab, and the history of Jamestown. And we try to figure out precisely what we've found and to write that up into a technical report. And that's what I'm working on right now. Our technical reports are very important because they present the most recent and updated analysis of the archaeological findings at historic Jamestown. Now, we've been putting out technical reports since the beginning of the project in 1994. Some of these reports cover multiple field seasons, some just one, but all of them present the most accurate and most recent analysis of our findings. Now, the reports are important in another way. They actually form the basis for a lot of other media that we produce. So books about the excavations, the signage that you see on site, interpretations to visitors, all of these things source their data from our technical reports, ultimately. Even our scholarly articles are going to draw on the technical reports for knowledge about what we found and where we found it. Putting together our technical reports is a major undertaking. It's a good rule of thumb in archaeology that however long it takes you to dig a site, it's going to take you at least three times that amount to write the technical report. I'm actually just one of several researchers who's working on our recent technical reports. In fact, most of the archaeology department is, directly or indirectly, working on our reports. Now, one of the first steps to putting these reports together, and a step that I'm working on right now, is reviewing the archaeology that came before us. What was done in a particular location in years past? Now, that means looking over earlier technical reports for Jamestown Rediscovery, but also reports produced about the work done by the National Park Service in the 1930s, 40s, and 50s. And there's one in particular that I've been working with lately. That's John Cotter's 1958 Archaeological Excavations at Jamestown. That summarizes several decades worth of excavations on Preservation Virginia property, historic Jamestown, and on the National Park Service side of the island. I've been looking specifically at the historic Jamestown part. Now, you can see here a map produced for the 1958 Cotter Report. That shows a portion of the Great Road, which was a historic road connecting Jamestown Island to the mainland. Cotter and his team uncovered portions of this Great Road, and in the past summer, we found another segment of it. And you can see that right here. Now, when we're reviewing earlier excavations like this, our geographic information system, or GIS, comes in really handy because we can very quickly figure out where the features were uncovered in past excavations and compare them to our modern excavations. So we can easily see, oh, here's where the Great Road that John Cotter found is, and here's where we found it, right next to each other. So we're still very early in the process of putting together our technical reports, but eventually, once they're finished, they're all going to be made available online on our website at historicjamestown.org. And in fact, all the previous technical reports are out there right now. So if you're interested, go to the website and download them, and you can see what we had put together for previous years' archaeology. Our website also has our monthly dig updates, which is a great place to see what we're working on in the field each month. Usually there are photos, sometimes videos that go along with that. We also have a YouTube channel, and the YouTube channel has videos like this, and overviews of what we're working on in the field and in the lab a lot of times. So definitely check those out. Thank you very much for watching Digging Deeper. Stay safe and tune in again for more updates from Historic Jamestown.